I'm going to make some strawberry pudding. This is such an easy recipe. It's a recipe that my mom has been making for years and years and years. She made it when I was a kid. We had it at most holidays. It's just easy and it's delicious. We're going to start out with buying a container of frozen strawberries. This is 10 ounces. You find it in your freezer section like this. You want the strawberries that are packed in their own juice. So you get that and then you strain them. And this is the strawberries, which are pretty pitiful looking when you come to think of it after you drain them. And here's the juice. This is an integral part of this recipe. So in a food processor, you take just the strawberries, put those in there, and we're going to give them just a little ride. I don't want it purified. I want a little bit of texture left, but not much. Then we're going to take this wonderful juice and we're going to put it in a pan. And I want to get all of it I can. You see the pan is warm. I've been warming it. Put it on our burner. And to that, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of powdered gelatin. You can buy this in the small packets in the supermarket. Since I do an awful lot of cooking and baking, I buy the giant economy size. And I'm just going to stir it around. And I don't want this to come to a boil. I just want that gelatin to kind of melt into the juice. And that should really only take about 2 minutes, maybe. Give it a lot of stirring so that gelatin breaks up. I don't want any lumps of gelatin. We had this pudding every single Christmas. And this is a single recipe. My mom always doubled the recipe because everyone loved it so much that we had to have seconds and thirds and sometimes more. So I'll give that like 2 minutes. Okay, that's been about 2 minutes and it's pretty soft. Again, I don't want this to come to a boil. So now I'm going to add it to those strawberries in the food processor. Again, I want to get as much of that juice as I can because it's so good. Now, another way that my mom always did this is instead of using the gelatin, my mom used a package of that gelatin, strawberry gelatin. But you can do that too. And all I want to do here is just mix it up. I'm done with that. Okay. Now I'm going to put this stuff away and get my mixer out, and we'll proceed to the second part of the recipe. Now it's time to finish up the strawberry pudding. I took the mixture of the juice and the gelatin out of the food processor and put it in a bowl. I did this for 2 reasons. I could have done it just that way, but I wanted you to see the motion of putting the pudding together in a glass bowl. So I have a cup of heavy cream. Let's not skimp. This is heavy cream. And I'm going to put it in my mixer. A generous cup, a little bit over, because I look at this and I say, I've lost some cream. And I could sit there and scrape it out, but that takes time. Now I'm going to whip it up. I don't want this to be stiff peaks. It's very hard to fold all of this into stiff peaks on the cream. So I want it to be soft peaks. So that's a couple minutes. It goes even faster if your mixer bowl and your beaters have been in the refrigerator before time. Cream is ready. What I mean by soft peaks is it doesn't quite stand up, but it's whipped. There's a lot of air in here, and that's what I want. So now we're going to put the cream into the strawberry juice. See what I mean? This is really a simple recipe, but it looks spectacular when you're finished, and I'll show you a couple of ways to do this. And now we just want to blend, turning the bowl and mixing it up. If this were stiff peaks that I put in there, this would be very hard to blend up with a strawberry. I've tried it. Just checking to see if there's any big pockets of strawberry that didn't get mixed in. That's pretty well blended. Now I'm choosing to serve this as individual desserts. My mom would have put this in a nice decorative pretty bowl and she would have scooped out individuals. But I have these pretty little individual trifle dishes, which I think look really cool. And I have some fresh strawberries. And what I'm going to do is what I've done here is I'm going to put some in so that they're facing the outside of the glass. So I have to cut off the top with the greens and I want a flat surface. And then I cut them down to make halves and just put them around the edges. Now these want to fall in, but I'm gonna put some of that mousse in there and use it to hold it, to hold them in place. You'll see. So, one more piece on that one. Okay, that's all we need there. So now, take some of that strawberry mousse, put it in the middle. And you'll see, this is pretty watery right now. This is going to set up in the refrigerator and it's going to become nice and thick. And so that's what they look like before they go in the refrigerator. I'm gonna finish filling the other four and then once they've hardened, about maybe 2 to 3 hours in a regular refrigerator, I'll bring them out and I'll show you how I decorate them. Here are our strawberry puddings out of the refrigerator. They're all nicely set up. I put a dollop of whipped cream on the top of each one. You can see the strawberries out the sides. Pretty dessert for a table. And I thought, well, garnish more. You could put chopped strawberries on here. Or why not gild the lily? Chocolate-covered strawberry on each one. Serve that to your guests, and I guarantee they're going to love your desserts. So there we go, our strawberry pudding.